Very good morning, dear student. Welcome to the Stars Point, dear student. Today we are taking the next topic of the probability, as we have already started the probability chapter, which is very interesting and very important. So here we see the statement of the base theorem, and also we see how we draw the formula for this theorem and their application, and some basic thing we also need for the base theorem, so that we have to see. So let's see what is this theorem and how we can use this in our solving the problem related to the probabilities. So if we are taking one example, suppose we are considering there are two bags. If we take two bags, bag first and bag second, and say bag first contain two white and three red balls. This contain two white plus three red balls, and bag second contain four white plus five red balls. So these are given case. Now if someone says we want to find the probability one ball is drawn from random from one of the bag. Means if we are drawn one ball from any bag randomly. So dear student, as we know that here two bags are given. So probability of selecting bag, if you are selecting first bag or second bag, that is equal. Which is equal to 1 by 2. Selecting of the bag first or second, it is 1 by 2. We can find the probability of selecting any of the bag, that is 1 by 2. Or probability of drawing a ball of a particular color from a particular bag. Suppose say what is the probability of getting a white ball from first bag or white ball from second bag, that we can easily find, because as you know that selecting bag is 1 by 2. Now to find a red ball from first bag, that will be 3 upon 5. So 1 by 2 into 3 by 5, you can find the probability. Similarly, if you want to find a white ball from second, that you can easily find 1 by 2 into 4 upon 9. So that can be we easily find. If we want to find the probability from the selecting bag of balls. So now say what? This says the other word, we can say that we can find the probability that ball drawn is of a particular color. We can easily find the probability of selecting a ball of a particular ball of a particular color from bag first or from bag second. It is very easily. Now can we find the probability that the ball drawn is a particular bag, say if the color of the ball drawn is given? Now question what say, if we say we are drawing the ball without seeing any ball, you have to draw out, then can you say what is the probability that this ball is come from or drawn from first bag? What is the probability that this ball, drawn ball, is belongs to the first, or it may be belongs to the second? So such type of probability is known as reverse probability. So here we want to find a reverse probability. So how to find the reverse probability? For that, a famous mathematician John Bayes solved this problem of the reverse probability. That's why he gives the formula. reverse probability. Why we call reverse? Because we draw the ball and we see color is already given. Generally, we are saying what is the probability of getting a red ball or white ball from bag first or second. This is given. But when you draw a ball and given that it is a white, then what is the probability that it drawn from bag first or it drawn from second? So that's why this type of probability is called as the reverse probability. And this reverse probability finding formula or theorem is given by a famous mathematician, that is John Bayes. So the name is given here, Bayes theorem. So now see, before this theorem we need some basic concept to prove this theorem or draw formula. We need some basic concept or some topic that we have to see. So first is the partition of sample space. Now what is the meaning of partition of a sample space? Dear student, as you already familiar with the sample space, it is a total possible outcome of an experiment. Clear? Now we see partition means we have to divide into subgroups. Clear? So let a set of an event, the definition I have written here, a set of events, there are n events, E1, E2, E3, En, is said to be a partition of a sample space if there are three conditions that should be satisfied by that partition or particular subset. You can say, like suppose we are taking how many events, n events. Then pairwise disjoint means EI intersection EJ equal to 5, where I not equal to J. Like you can say E1 intersection E2 should be 5, they have no common. E2 intersection E3 again 5, E1 intersection E3 that is also 5, and so on. In this way, pairwise disjoint means they have any two subset have no common element. So such type condition should be there. So for partition, first condition pairwise disjoint, and second say the union of all the events, we get the again sample space. That is E1 union E2 union E3 up to En. That is S. Means they are mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. So this is, we know that E1 intersection EI intersection EG means the event are mutually exclusive and their union equal to S, that the events are exhaustive. Then PI is greater than zero. I means E's probability is greater than zero, that is not equal to zero. If any partition satisfied these three conditions, dear student, then we call the partition, this the events are called as partition of the sample space. So in other words, the event E1, E2, E3 up to En represent a partition of a sample space S if they are pairwise disjoint, exhaustive and have non-zero probabilities. Pairwise disjoint, exhaustive and non-zero probability. So in theoretically we can write this way. So for example, we say that any two non-empty events E and its complement E naught, this form a partition of the S, E and E naught. Now they have no common point, so pairwise disjoint. If you find a union E union E naught, that is again S, and the probability of this will be greater than 0. So we can say E and complement E or E and E naught always form the partition of the sample space S. So now we can see, as we have seen in the figure, like in 11th class we see, we also draw in the previous class, suppose two events are given, E, F. This region is called E intersection F. This region is called as E intersection F naught, and this region is called E naught intersection F. So these three form a partition of the given sample space. E intersection F naught, E intersection, and you may also write this one, E naught intersection F naught. So there are how many regions? This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. All four regions have no common element. That's why they are pairwise disjoints. Which events? E intersection F naught, E intersection F, E naught intersection F, E naught intersection F naught. All four events are pairwise disjoint. Now you can find union. If you find union of 1, 2, 3, 4 region, means if you add all the element of 1, 2, 3, 4. So what we get? We get again this universal set U or S. That is the sample space of the given experiment. So we can say this also form a partition of the sample space of an experiment. So we are giving here two examples. And similarly, you can say all other may be there. Like suppose you are considering the real number. Then in real number, if you make the partition, we can say rational and irrational number. They form again, they have no common, and their union again a real number. So that is also. So there are so many examples of the partitions. Clear? So we shall now prove a theorem that is called a theorem of total probability. So after this partition, we need one more, that is the theorem or total probability. So see, theorem of total probability, theorem of total probability. So what is the theorem of total probability? So here we also write these laws, that E1, E2, E3 up to EN be a partition. So what is the partition that we have already seen? So we may write here definition for total probability or formula for, let E1 a set containing event E1, E2, E3 up to EN be a partition of the sample space S, of the sample space S, and suppose that each of the event E1, E2, 3 are non-zero probability, or they form a partition, then automatically we see these are the probability is non-zero, and A be any event associated with A, and A be any event which is associated with all the associated with events E1, E2, E3 up to EN, then now we have a formula for this. Total probability of event A or probability of happening event A is equal to P E1 into P A of the E1, P E2 into P A of the E2, and so on. In this way, probability of P E N into P A oblique T1. So this all will be related to the conditional probability. Here we are using, this is the conditional probability. So this is known as total probability. Clear? Or you may write in the form of summation also. This can be written as a summation of I from 1 to n pi into p a of a pi. So we may also use in the summation form. So this is known as total probability. Now what is the meaning of the total probability? We may give an example in our daily life so you can understand. Suppose this year your target is to score marks 90% in board exam. So what will be the probability that you should get the finally marks as a 90%? So here student, as you see, there are so many problems affect this result. If you are making target, then like this year, there is a lockdown, there is no school, no class. So all will affect. Suppose there are some other problem at your home, then they also affect your target. So affecting all these targets, what is the probability that you score the 90%? Similarly, you take one more example, like in a factory, suppose there is a target of completing any work, then what will be the target can be completed in probability, we can say. What is the probability that work will be completed on time? Suppose there are some obstacles are there or restrictions are there. Suppose there is a strike of the worker or there may be problem of the money or there may be problem of the weather. So there are so affecting factors are there. They affect the target or work. But if after all, what is the probability that work is completed on a time? So that we called a total probability. Like suppose here E is the your target to score the marks 90%. But even that your health is not support you. E2, schools are not running. E3, you have no books, and so on. So many problems are there. Still, what is the probability that you should get the marks as a 90%? So that. So here you can say we are drawing a figure. This figure what say? E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E8. There are these problems in your life. आपके लाइफ में बहुत सारी समस्याएं आती है. आप पढ़ने बैठ गए, आपका मन नहीं कर रहा है, इवन फिर भी मार के जबरदस्ती पढ़ रहे हो कि 90% बनाना है. आपके दोस्त का फोन आ गया E2, जैसे तैसे दोस्त को बचा के कह दिया कि घर पे नहीं या कैसे भी. आपका कोई मिलने वाला रिश्तेदार आ गया, खास खास आपका जो कई सालों बाद आया है, आप भी घर पे रहेगा एक महीना, वो आपकी पढ़ाई को डिस्टर्ब करेगा. E4, आपका स्कूल बंद है लॉकडाउन से. E5, ऑनलाइन क्लास आप अटेंड नहीं कर रहे हो क्योंकि आपका मन नहीं कर रहा है. ऑनलाइन क्लास चालू करके और मोबाइल को रख करके साइड में गाने सुन रहे हो, म्यूजिक सुन रहे हो. E5, मम्मी पापा ने बढ़िया फोन दिला दिया है, नेटवर्क बढ़िया आ रहा है, लेकिन हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, रूम बंद करके दूसरी साइड में विजिट कर रहे हैं. इस तरह से आपके साथ में कई समस्याएं आएगी, चाहते भी अनचाहते. फिर भी आपका गोल क्या है, 90% लाना है. इन सभी से लड़ते हुए 90% लाना है. दैट इज द टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी और थ्योरम ऑफ द टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी. क्लियर? सो हियर वी डिस्कस डिफरेंट टाइप, कंडीशन आर गिवन, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट कंडीशन you have to score the good mark. So P1, PA of this. So conditional क्या है कि आपके पास दोस्त का फोन आ गया, फिर भी आपको ध्यान रखना है कि मुझे पढ़ना है. आप बीमार हो गए E2, फिर भी आपको ध्यान रखना है कि 90% लाना है. आपका नेटवर्क काम नहीं कर रहा है, फिर भी आपको टारगेट देखना है कि आपको कॉस्ट करना है. सो यूजिंग ऑल दीज डिफिकल्टीज और रिस्ट्रिक्शन हाउ वी गेट दैट इज नोन एज ए टोटल प्रोबेबिलिटी. क्लियर. सो नाउ वी सी द प्रूफ ऑफ दिस थ्योरम. हाउ वी कैन प्रूव दिस थ्योरम. सो लेट दीज इवेंट्स आर गिवन इन प्रूफ यू राइट गिवन E1, E2, E3 अप टू EN फॉर्म द पार्टीशन ऑफ सैंपल स्पेस दैट इज E1 यूनियन E2 यूनियन E3 अप टू यूनियन EN दैट इज S. This is we are given. Also we are given pairwise disjoint because they form the so these two conditions we have to given. Now for any event A, so you can say for any event A we have A intersection S equal to A because A is a subset of S. This is our sample space S, rectangular form sample space S. So A is the subset of S. So A can be written as A intersection S. You can write. Now if you see S can be replaced by so A equal to A intersection S. S is here A1 union E2 union E3 union EN. S can be replaced because this follows the partition of the set S. Now we can say using the property of the intersection or union. So what we see? A can be written A intersection E1 union A intersection E2 union A intersection E3 union A intersection EN. Clear? Now we can see here that these events are subset of EI and EJ. We know that EY, EJ are disjoint. So these are also disjoint. Which event are disjoint? Like you can say here A intersection E1 and A intersection E2. These are disjoint event. Why disjoint? Because E1 and E2 have no common element. Then their intersection will have no common. Similarly, E3 and E2 are disjoint, then their intersection with A will be. So all these are disjoint. These all are pointwise disjoint. So as we know formula for probability of A union B equal to PA plus PB if A and B are disjoint. We have used formula A and B are disjoint, then probability of A union B equal to PA plus PB because then we are not using the probability of their intersection, that will be 0. So here also we can say these are union is given in between. So they are pairwise disjoint. So if you find a probability throughout this or on both sides, then what we can write? Probability of A equal to probability of A intersection E1 plus probability of A intersection E2 plus probability of A intersection E3 plus probability of A intersection EN. All we have to add. Clear? Now by multiplication rule of the probability. So as you know the multiplication rule of the probability in each case. So P A intersection E1, a probability of happening both the event is equal to probability of A into probability of E1, A of the E1. So this can be written as probability of E1 into probability of A of the E1. As we have seen in the case of the E intersection F is equal to PE into PF of the E or PF into PE of the F. We use the multiplication rule of the probability. In the previous class we see the multiplication rule of the probability. For this formula PA intersection E1 can be written as P E1 into P A oblique E1. Similarly in this, so that will be gives you the result. And so on. E N into probability of A oblique E N. That we want to prove. So this is the formula for the total probability for an event. Now here one example is also given for solving or for application of this. So you may write down this for the formula we use. So that say a person has undertaken a construction job. So person has that a work construction job under taken, completing a job. The probabilities are there will be strike. So probability of strike, that is given 0.65. That there is a strike 0.6. 0.80 the construction job will be completed on time. So we can say completed on time. If no strike, there is no strike, then job will be completed. That is probability is given as 0.80. And 0.32 that the construction job will be completed. So completed on time if there is a strike. That is 0.32. And then say determine the probability that the construction job will be completed on time. So you have to find out that the construction job will be completed on time. So what problem says? Problem says a person has undertaken a construction job. Target to complete the construction job. Now there are probabilities that 0.65% there is a strike. So probability of not strike. So probability of not strike, that is not event, 1 minus 0.65, that is 0.35. Clear? 0.35, there is no strike. Then what's the conditional probability given? This is the conditional. Work will be completed if no strike, 0.80. Work will be completed if there is a strike. So first thing is either strike or not strike. Then what is the probability? That's why these are the two conditional probability. So we can say here our target is to complete the job. So let in solution write that A be the event that construction of job is completed. Clear? A be the event that job will be completed on time. This is we are taking completed on time. So what we have to find, what is the probability? This we want to find. Now there are two cases, either there is a strike or not. So we can say, let B be the event, there is strike, so we have B is a, then B dash or B naught be the event, there is no strike. So now what is the probability that there is a strike? That is 0.6. What is probability that there is no strike? That is 0.35. Now we see the probability of conditional A oblique B. Now what is the meaning of this? Probability of A oblique B. Now B is already happened. It means B means strike is there. A means completing the job. If there is a strike, then what is the probability that job is completed? Clear? So B, we are saying there is a strike, then job will be completed, given as 3.32. Probability of A oblique B dash, there is no strike. Then what is the probability of completing the job? No strike, completing job. 0.82. So now using this formula, using total probability formula, probability of A equal to probability of B into probability of A of A B. Now there are only two constants. So we use formula for two, because there are two cases, either strike or not. There is no third factor given. If third is given, then we take third case. Otherwise, you take these two, now put the values and solve. So you get the answer. PB is given as 0.65. PA oblique B, that is 0.32. Probability of B dash, that is 0.35. A oblique B dash, that is 0.83. So multiply and add, that will gives you the total probability, which is equal to 0.488. So this is the probability of completing the job under the condition or under the given condition. So in this condition, one can find the value. So now we see the formula after this example for Bayes theorem. How we write the formula, and in next time we see the their examples. So this theorem says, Bayes theorem, if E1, E2, E3 up to EN are non-empty events with a constituent partition are non-zero events and associated with the partition of the sample space S. Then what we get? PEI oblique A is equal to PEI into PA oblique EI upon total probabilities. I from 1 to N. So this can be also replaced by A. So may be written in this way, EI, A oblique EI upon total probability E. So this theorem or this result is known as the Bayes theorem. So now this is we prove here. As we know that by formula of conditional, by conditional probability. In this, if you are using the conditional probability of pi oblique a, pai oblique a is equal to pai intersection a upon formula, you can say pei oblique a equal to pei intersection a upon pa. This is the conditional probability of an event. Now see, we can use the multiplication rule of the probability in the numerator. So this equal to, here you use the multiplication rule of the probability because both events are happening together. So probability of EI intersection A is equal to PEI into PA of the EI. So that will be the given answer. So we want that EI of the A. So this formula we have to say based on PEI into PA of the EI is equal to total probability. So this result will be we use as a calculating the reverse probability. Why we call it is a reverse? Because we are given already A. Then what is probability that it belongs to the even? Like suppose we are drawing a board and we say this board is belongs to the which pair? Either first or second. So in this way we can find a reverse probability of an event. So in next video, dear student, we have to see how we can use this formula. So that is very important. So thanks for watching. Have a nice day. To be continued with us for more videos.